Good morning. Today we'll be doing the Liturgy of the Hours morning prayer for May 6th. Today is the Monday in the sixth week of Easter. Let's have that moment of silence to prepare us for a prayer. God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia.
Jesus Christ is risen today.
As a deer longs for flowing streams, so my soul longs for you, my God. Alleluia.
Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul is yearning for you, my God.
My soul is thirsting for God, the God of my life. When can I enter and see the face of God?
My tears have become my bread, by night, by day, as I hear it said all the day long, where is your God?
These things will I remember as I pour out my soul, how I would lead the rejoicing crowd into the house of God, amid cries of gladness and thanksgiving, the throng wild with joy.
Why are you cast down, my soul? Why groan within me? Hope in God, I will praise Him still, my Savior and my God.
My soul is cast down within me as I think of you, from the country of Jordan and Mount Hermon, from the hills of Mizar.
Deep is calling on deep, in the roar of waters, your torrents and your waves swept away me.
By the day the Lord will send His loving kindness, by night I will sing to Him, praise the God of my life.
I will say to God, my rock, why have you forgotten me? Why do I go mourning, oppressed by the foe?
with cries that pierce me to the heart. My enemies revile me, saying to me all day long, "Where is your God?
Why are you cast down, my soul? Why groan within me? Hope in God, I will praise him still,
my
Savior and my God.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
As a deer longs for flowing streams, so my soul longs for you, my God. Alleluia. Fill Zion with your praises, Lord, and let your wonders be proclaimed. Alleluia.
Come to our aid, O God of the universe, and put all the nations in dread of you. Raise your hand against the heathen, that they may realize your power.
As you have used us to show them your holiness, so now use them to show us your glory. Thus they will know, as we know, that there is no God but you.
Give new signs and work new wonders. Show forth the splendor of your right hand and arm.
Gather all the tribes of Jacob, that they may inherit the land as of old. Show mercy to the people called by your name, Israel, whom you named your firstborn.
Take pity on your holy city, Jerusalem, your dwelling place. Fill Zion with your majesty, your temple with your glory.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Fill Zion with your praises, Lord, and let your wonders be proclaimed. Alleluia. The glory of God illumines the city. The Lamb of God is its light. Alleluia.
The heavens proclaim the glory of God, and the firmament shows forth the work of his hands. Day unto day takes up the story, and night unto night makes known the message.
No speech, no word, no voice is heard, yet their span extends through all the earth, their words to the utmost bounds of the world.
There he has placed a tent for the sun. It comes forth like a bridegroom coming from his tent, rejoices like a champion to run its course.
At the end of the sky is the rising of the sun, to the furthest end of the sky is its course. There is nothing concealed from its burning heat.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The glory of God illumines the city. The Lamb of God is its light. Alleluia.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. The word is near you, on your lips and in your heart, that is, the word of faith which we preach. For if you confess with your lips that Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Faith in the heart leads to justification. Confession on the lips to salvation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is risen. Alleluia, alleluia. As we heard in the scriptures today from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans, if we confess with our lips that Jesus is Lord and believe in our hearts that God raised him from the dead, we will be saved. Our faith is something that we need to work every day. We need to ask our Lord to increase our faith daily for us to continue in this journey, in this marathon back home. We need the Lord. There's no doubt about it. I do believe that one point and another, we all have tried to do things without the hand of the Lord, and we have come short, we have failed. At least I have. So that proves to me that without him, I'm nothing. I'm gonna get lost. I'm gonna get pretty much consumed into this world, to the temptation of this world, the darkness of this world. But thank God to you, Lord, that you are there always to save me, to protect me, and to protect all of us, your children. In the scripture, you also said, Lord, you are the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. So you have the gate, the door that he opens for us, the eternity. We receive the Holy Spirit through our baptism and also in the confirmation. The Holy Spirit, that is the third person of the Trinity, which comes from the love of the Father and the Son. That's what the Holy Spirit is. And we need to embrace the Holy Spirit, allow him to live in our lives, to guide us, to protect us from the enemy, and also to help us continue this marathon, this journey to the promised land. Brothers and sisters, let's ask the Lord to increase our faith, to give it us the strength to move forward to his plan, the plan that the Lord has for you and for me, to bring us the salvation to all the people that we encounter. It started from our family members and people in our daily lives. Let's continue these morning prayers, holding the Lord's hands and walking with him side by side, if we really wanted to be with him for all eternity. God bless you all and have a wonderful day.
The Lord is risen from the tomb. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord is risen from the tomb. Alleluia, alleluia.
He hung upon the cross for us.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
The Lord is risen from the tomb. Alleluia, alleluia.
By raising Jesus Christ from the dead, God has given us a new birth to a living hope in the promise of an inheritance that will last forever. Alleluia.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free.
He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David.
Through his holy prophets, he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us.
He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant.
This was his oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life.
You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins.
In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadows of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
By raising Jesus Christ from the dead, God has given us a new birth to a living hope in the promise of inheritance that will last forever. Alleluia. God the Father was glorified in the death and resurrection of his Son. Let us pray to him with confidence, saying, Lord, enlighten our minds.
Father of lights, you bathe the world in splendor when Christ rose again in glory.
Fill our minds with the light of faith.
Through the resurrection of your Son, you opened for us the way to eternal life.
As we work today, sustain us with the hope of glory.
Through your risen Son, you sent the Holy Spirit into the world.
Set our hearts on fire with spiritual love.
May Jesus Christ, who was crucified to set us free,
be today our salvation and redemption.
Let us pause for a moment to lift up our prayers and petitions to God our Father. Heavenly Father, we lift up to you our prayers and our petitions, together with the prayers and petitions of each and everyone who are praying with us this morning. We ask, dear Father, that you hear and answer each and every prayer as we pray,
Lord, enlighten our minds. Gathering our prayers and praises into one, we now pray the prayer Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. God of mercy, may our celebration of your Son's resurrection help us to experience its effect in our lives. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thank you for praying with us.
We hope you can join us again tomorrow.
Same time,
same place,
same channel. Have a great day.